When it comes to providing value for money, I don't think many projects could claim to provide the same level of benefits as the upgrade of the core valley lines in South East Wales when compared to the cost. And although the cost has increased from £734 million to around £1 billion, I still believe it provides exceptional value for money. I admit this word is often overused, but I believe this project has the potential to be transformational. I know some will say more could be done to provide more benefits for Cardiff itself, but South Wales Metro will provide transformational benefits to communities, amongst which are some of the most deprived in Wales. South Wales Metro will deliver a 4 trains per hour daytime service during the week on 4 key valley routes, whilst the Coryton line will retain a 2 trains per hour service. The key to this capacity increase is the electrification of the core valley network, along with signalling upgrades and the introduction of new rolling stock, with new bi-mode and tri-mode trains introduced, which have far superior acceleration when compared to the outgoing Class 150 DMUs. In all, 170 single track kilometres or 105 miles of electrification will be delivered across the Core Valley lines. The Core Valley lines include the Aberdare, Coryton, Merthyr Tydfil, Rumney and Treherbert lines to Cardiff Queen Street. The Core Valley upgrade also incorporates the Cardiff City line as far as Neenium Park and the Bute Town branch line, which is also referred to as the Cardiff Bay line, to Cardiff Bay railway station. I'll be talking more about the Cardiff Bay line in the next video, so make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss that video. The Metro upgrade is being delivered by the primary delivery partner AMI Infrastructure Wales, which also manages the Core Valley infrastructure and will continue to do so once the upgrade is complete. Transport for Wales, which assumed direct control of railway services in 2021, will continue to manage the day-to-day operation of passenger services as it does now. To enable the upgrade, TfW took ownership of the Core Valley network in 2020. It then subsequently leased the infrastructure to AMI Infrastructure Wales. It's a complicated arrangement, but it ultimately means that Transport for Wales owns the infrastructure and AIW maintains and manages the infrastructure on TfW's behalf. Network Rail continues to own and maintain Cardiff Central Station and the Vale of Glamorgan line, which has caused some controversy, and Professor Mark Barry has argued that it will mean the line will not see the same level of benefits as the Core Valley network. This is because Network Rail currently doesn't have any plans to electrify or upgrade the Vale of Glamorgan route. But as a whole, South East Wales passengers will benefit from the introduction of new trains. Rumney and Coryton services to Penarth, Barry Island and Bridgend will be served by Class 756 tri-mode multiple units, which can operate on overhead lines, batteries and engine power, with the engines needed to operate on the Vale of Glamorgan line. The Merthyr Tydfil, Aberdare and Treherbert lines will be served by Class 398 bi-mode tram trains, which can take power from overhead lines and batteries. The use of bi-mode and tri-mode units has allowed AMI to use discontinuous electrification, which I know has its critics, but means that the price of the upgrade has been kept comparatively low, at least in terms of UK electrification, which ultimately means the upgrade was deemed deliverable. The longest valley line section without wires will be between Caerphilly Station and Lisvain and Thornhill on the Rumney line. Between the two stations lies the 1.8 kilometre or 1.1 mile long Caerphilly tunnel, which couldn't be cost effectively electrified due to the constrained tunnel bore. The OLE masts, which were recently installed at Caerphilly Station, are for an overhead conductor, which will be used to charge the batteries of the Class 756s when they're waiting at Platform 1. The Class 398s will operate on routes with shorter, non-electrified sections. Therefore, the units only require batteries. Although, having said that, there are some lengthy sections on the route without wires, such as the 2.7km section between Taffswell and the M4. Although the new accessible overbridge at Taffswell station looks high enough for OLE, no wires will be installed through the station. Nor will wires be installed from the main line to the connection for the new Class 398 depot, which is just to the north of Cardiff Road. The new depot does have wires installed within the stabling area, so the tram trains will be able to charge before heading out onto the network. Cardiff Road is a good example of a key main road which would have been difficult to raise to allow for OLE to be installed. It perhaps epitomises the issue of trying to electrify the valley's lines, with many road bridges which would be difficult to adjust given the topography, which leaves little room on which to build infrastructure. That's not to say that all road bridges won't have wires installed underneath, and there are sections where track has been lowered or bridges raised. But some bridges would have provided a particular challenge, and as such, adjusting them wouldn't have been cost effective. The longer sections of this continuous electrification will take the form of non-wired sections. However, some non-electrified sections will have wires installed. However, the wires will not be live. These sections are called permanently earthed sections. PES is used where there is sufficient clearance for OLE to be installed, but where there is insufficient clearance for a live section. This has the benefit of allowing the pantograph to remain in the raised position, but allows for the contact wire to be placed in a lower or higher position than standard. When entering and leaving non-wired sections, the pantograph will have to be lowered and raised, which will be controlled automatically using RFID or radio frequency identification devices, which will tell the trains when to raise or lower the pantographs. The RFID signal will also tell the trains when to switch between overhead line or battery power. Installation of the wires on the Treherbert, Aberdare and Merthyr lines is complete and testing is underway. Those lines will eventually be served by Class 398 CityLink units. However, the Class 756s will be introduced on these routes initially. This will allow TfW to bring forward some of the benefits of the upgrade prior to the introduction of the Class 398s, once the construction of the depot is fully complete and testing has taken place. These 756s are expected to enter service this winter, with the Class 398s expected to be introduced next year. The reasoning behind the use of tram trains is a topic which I'll discuss in the next video. Once the Class 398s enter service, the 756s will be introduced on the Rumney and Currington lines. This will in turn mean the Class 231s can move to operate between Cheltenham Spa and Bridgend, and on the Ebervale line to Cardiff Central. Work to electrify the Currington and Rumney lines is still ongoing, although I believe electrification of the Currington line, which is relatively short, is almost complete. Obviously, electrification of the Currington and Rumney lines will have to be completed to allow for the introduction of the 756s. The Ebervale line falls outside the Core Valley upgrade. However, passengers will benefit from the introduction of Class 231s, which are very similar to the Class 756s, which are both based on Stadler's ubiquitous flirt design. It may have taken longer than anticipated, and there may have been plenty of issues with Transport for Wales services over the past 6 years. However, the completion of the South Wales Metro will be a cause for celebration, and will hopefully provide a turning point for TfW, which will benefit passengers for decades to come.